知聲明呢個禮拜嘅課題幾深下嘅嚇，呢個就係 ambiguity， 形容詞係 ambiguous， 意思就係 having more than one possible meaning， 多過一個可能意思。ambiguity 係任何語文嘅大忌，應該要避免。我問你啦 ，as well as 咩意思啊？你答話 in addition to， 仲舉例埋添。He is kind as well as rich， 意思就係佢不但有錢啊，仲好仁慈添。冇錯啦，你聽呢一句啦。Mr. Wong, as well as his friends, ran 100 meters. 點解啊？你答話，哦，好簡單啫，黃先生同佢個朋友咁走咗100米啦，冇錯噃。不過啊 ，well 仲有其他嘅解法噶嘛，可以解好叻噶嘛。好啦，正話嗰句咪可以理解為 Mr. Wong ran 100 meters as well as his friends， 即係咧，黃先生走100米比佢個朋友咧毫不遜色喎。你睇到個 ambiguity 嘛？如果睇到咧，點樣避免法咧？點樣可以清楚表達你想表達嘅意思咧？聽日開股。Mr. Wong, as well as his friends, ran 100 meters。呢句冇錯嘅，好可惜有 ambiguity， 有誤會嘅可能。點樣去避免誤會咧？有兩個方法。第一個就係 Mr. Wong, like his friends, ran 100 meters。用個 like 字代咗 as well as， 咁咪只有一個意思嘅啫，就係黃先生正如佢個朋友咁走咗100米。第二個方法啦 ，Mr. Wong was as good as his friends in running 100 meters。呢句有一個意思就係黃先生走100米，比起佢嘅朋友毫不遜色。到今日嘅難題啦，你睇呢句 ，When did you arrange to meet him on Saturday night？ 又係有 ambiguity 嘅噃。第一個可能就係根據個文字次序咧，就係 When did you arrange？ 你幾時安排啦？但係一般人嘅理解多數係你安排咗星期六晚幾時或者幾多點見佢啊？有雙重意思咧，點樣避免咧？請你諗諗。When did you arrange to meet him on Saturday night？ 照文字嘅次序問嘅係幾時安排，為求清楚，可以咁樣講 ：On what date did you arrange to meet him on Saturday night？ 如果星期六晚啊仲未到嘅，我哋可以咁樣講 ：When on Saturday night are you to meet him？如果星期六已成過去嘅，我哋可以咁講 ：When on Saturday night were you to meet him？ 好啦，解決咗尋日嘅難題啦，今日又有新嘅練習兩句。第一句就係 I'm not going out because it is raining。咩意思咧？係我而家唔出去就係因為落緊雨，或者係我要出去並非因為落緊雨。第二句，你係紅歌星賺好多錢，人都話你為錢而唱歌，點不知你話？I'm not singing for that reason， 咩意思？係我並非因為錢而唱歌，或者就係因為嫌錢太多，所以我決定唔唱歌。你睇到個 ambiguity， 聽日咧我先提供我嘅意見。解決尋日兩個疑難，第一個就係 I'm not going out because it is raining。如果要清楚表示因為落緊雨而決定唔出去嘅咧。建築文字好簡單，喺個 because 前面加個 comma， 説話時稍頓就得噶啦。另一個方法咧就係將個理由擺喺前邊 ，because it is raining， I'm not going out。如果要表示我要出去，並非因為落緊雨，就係 I'm going out， comma not because it is raining。第二個疑難啦 ，I'm not singing for that reason。如果要表示並非為咗某個原因而唱歌嘅咧，有兩個方法。第一個就係 that is not why I'm singing。第二個咧就係 I'm singing, comma not for that reason。如果要表示正為咗某個原因而決定唔唱歌嘅咧，有兩個方法。That is why I'm not singing。第二咧就係 for that reason I'm not singing。你睇到避免 ambiguity 方法往往唔止一個。今日大講大笑提出三個標題，裏邊全部有曬 ambiguity， 好荒謬，好滑稽。第一個嚟自英國有一間出名嘅搬運公司，自稱為 Removers of Distinction， 原來嘅意思咧就係出色嘅搬運者。殊不知 Remover 可以解消除者 ，Distinction 可以解聲譽，因此 Removers of Distinction 可以理解為消除聲譽嘅專家。第二個標題係嚟自美國嘅有一間大嘅電腦公司，生意走下坡，發表咗篇文章題為 Competing with Better Products。我嘅理解咧就係咩咧？同人家勝我一籌的產品競爭，擺曬大烏龍。第三個標題嚟自香港嘅，我睇到係咁樣。你知啦 ，drug abuse 就係濫用藥物啦 ，anti-drug 就反毒啦。個標題就係 anti-drug abuses， 我的理解就是什么呢？反毒的弊病或者反毒行动的过态措施。以上的标题不是改一个字两个字可以改得完的，一定要承认错误重新想过完。